Hey, it's Brewbird. I'm a Canadian distiller making spirits in England. If you're interested in distilling or the drinks industry, then this is the channel to subscribe to. In this video, I'm coming up with my very own limoncello recipe. So let's go! So how did I come up with my limoncello recipe? Well, I did what I expect most of you would do. I went on Google and YouTube and found as many limoncello recipes as possible and just tried to learn as much about the drink as I could. From what I could gather after reading dozens of articles online, the process of making limoncello is fairly straightforward. The ingredients are just lemon peels, 96% neutral grain spirit, water, and white sugar. That's it. I did see some people squeezing a little bit of lemon juice into their limoncellos, but for the most part, most people seem to only use the lemon peel in their recipes. I was surprised to learn that there's no distilling of lemons involved in making limoncello. You just steep the peels in spirit and wait for the spirit to extract the color and flavor from the peels. Anyways, after a few hours of online research, I wrote up a proposed plan of action for developing my recipe. So my plan was to make four 500 milliliter samples. The first sample would have X grams of lemon peels steeped in 500 milliliters of 96% neutral grain spirit. The second sample would have half the amount of lemon peels steeped in 500 milliliters of spirit. And this was to test the amount of lemon peels we would need. I wanted to see if half the amount of lemon peels steeped for a longer time would give us a comparable flavor to more peels steeped for a shorter length of time. For the third sample, I wanted to see what would happen if I added in the juice of the lemons I peeled. So I steeped X grams of lemon peels in 500 milliliters of NGS and also added in the juice from those lemons as well. In the fourth sample, I have the amount of lemon peels and lemon juice used to see if that would still give me a nice tasting limoncello. Even though I saw very few people adding lemon juice into their limoncello, most of those people were home enthusiasts, so it was easy for them to find other uses for the lemon juice. However, at our distillery, we're hoping to make a big batch of limoncello, closer to 100 liters, which will take a lot of lemons. While a home enthusiast can easily use the juice of the peeled lemons to make lemonade or lemon cake, it's a much bigger headache when you have hundreds of peeled lemons to deal with. I thought if we could just use the lemon juice in our limoncello, that would be an ideal situation, since we wouldn't have to figure out what else to do with them. Then I went to the grocery store and purchased 16 unwaxed lemons. In Italy, Sorrento lemons are traditionally used to make limoncello. But these supermarket lemons are most likely of the Eureka or Lisbon variety. I'm using unwaxed lemons here since you don't want wax to get dissolved in the alcohol. Then you'll just end up drinking it, which isn't so nice. I gave the lemons a good scrub under cold water to make sure they were clean and dried them. Then I got down to the business of peeling them. It said online that when you peel the skins, you should try to avoid the pith, the white part, as much as possible, and that both sides of the peel should be yellow. I tried my best, but the exterior of the lemons was so tough, so I got a lot of pith when I was peeling. I really didn't want to screw up this limoncello recipe, so after I finished peeling the lemons, I went back with a knife and scraped some additional pith off. Then I weighed out all the peels and divided them up to put into my neutral grain spirit. After that, I took some of the lemons and juiced them, and then passed the juice through a strainer to remove the seeds and the flesh. Then I weighed out the juice and put it into two of my four samples. We have the full amount of peels, and in this one, the full amount of peels and the juice from those lemons. Then we have half the amount of peels and half the amount of peels with the juice of those lemons. I'll just cover these up with plastic bags to keep the alcohol from evaporating and put them into this dark and cool cupboard to steep. It's been 3 days and I'm just pouring out samples of each lemon spirit for everyone to try. I noticed the sample with half the lemon peels had no color, whereas in the one with the full amount of peels, it had turned a beautiful yellow color already. Let's listen to what everyone thought.
I like how your scale's going up. That's lemony. That's very lemony. I can probably guess what the next one is. That's a lemon. That's good, I like it. I think it's good.
Well, yeah, we need to leave it a little bit longer, but the colour, that's awesome, really.
Do you think the lemon in there, you know, you get the sugar and water, correct?
Sorry.
But the lemon is definitely there, massively, like, and nice lemon. Like Peter said, it's not that artificial washing up liquid sort of that lemon flavour that you're getting through.
This one is there.
Yeah.
this
is a bit of water there.
Bitter.
I don't think I would like that.
This is so bitter.
So that kind of hints towards what will happen after you've allowed the lemon juice to set in on these anyway. Mm-hmm. So does it need to be in there? I suppose the answer is yes, because it just makes the process simpler. You peel, put them in, squeeze the lemon juices that you want to put in, rather than having to peel them, put them into the actual liquid, and then hold on to the lemons and the juice for a later point to put in. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. At this point, the sample with the lemon juice was still being considered, but we decided to no longer work with the two samples that contained half the amount of peels, since the flavor and color from them was so weak. After waiting another week, I made up 6 samples of limoncello for everyone to try. This time, I added water and simple syrup to the samples I made. I took 10 milliliters of the lemon spirit concentrate and mixed it with 20 milliliters of reverse osmosis water. And then I put in different amounts of sugar syrup. One sample had 1 teaspoon of simple syrup, another had 2 teaspoons, and a third had 3 teaspoons. For the other 3 samples, I substituted a portion of the reverse osmosis water with different amounts of freshly squeezed lemon juice. Let's see what David and Simon thought.
That's quite pleasant, actually. That's not quite rough, is it?
You were afraid to try it, weren't you?
The first one was really tart.
Yeah, but you've still got the sourness of the lemon there, but then the sweetness on the back of it. So actually, that's quite pleasant.
And I'm still getting that lemony, mentally flavour that I said finish it.
Yeah.
It feels quite smooth as well, doesn't it?
It does, yeah.
Okay. So this is the best creation we've had so far.
That's juicy. It tastes juicy.
That one's like much more smooth.
Yeah. The other ones taste more like a limoncello I'm used to. Actually, smoother than I'm used to. This one's just... It's hard to describe. It builds my mouth with juice, so it's making me salivate a bit.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's more watery.
After this tasting session, we decided to not include any lemon juice in our limoncello recipe, as it just made our limoncello very bitter tasting. The limoncellos made with just the peel were very smooth and easy to drink. These limoncellos had an intense lemony flavor and aroma, and we decided to go with the sample with 1 teaspoon of simple syrup in it, since it had the best balance of lemon and sweetness. A week later, Simon brought in two of the limoncellos he had purchased while on vacation in Italy. I covered both bottles up and we did a blind tasting, comparing our limoncello with the other two.
Where we're out, you definitely get that tart kick at the start, and then it's sweet afterwards. I don't really get much of that tartness with this first one. This one, I don't know, it's just an odd fish meat.
Yeah, that one's just
bad. Yeah, I don't like that one.
So you managed to figure it out.
Oh, yeah. they're completely different. So this is more of that, like, when you're having out, it's definitely like a mentally or lemony flavour that you get.
Yeah.
Like you can feel it, like the way that mental works, you know. It's, these two are just definitely a lot sweeter than our one.
Yeah.
David and Simon preferred our limoncello as the other two were much sweeter and syrup-like. One of them also had some flavorings added to it, which gave it a strange, artificial, herbal-like taste, which was very unpleasant. Whew! I'm glad I was able to successfully pull off making a limoncello. During our tastings, I prepared limoncello samples with the lemon peel spirit that had been steeped for different times. 3 days, 10 days, 15 days, and 20 days. I thought 3 days was too short, but the lemon peel steeped at the 10-day mark versus the 20-day mark didn't really have too much of a difference flavor-wise. So I think I'd steep the peels for at least 10 days, or until the peels are an opaque white color, because that will indicate that the peels have given away most of their flavor and color to the spirit. After that, Simon asked me to write up a recipe sheet with a scaled-up version of the limoncello recipe we had picked in our tasting session. So, it was a success! I hope you enjoyed watching me experiment with different limoncello recipes. In the meantime, please support the channel by giving this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button for more distilling and distillery videos. This is Brewbird sending good vibes your way. I'll see you next time.